Welcome to the testing world. So in previous session, we have seen how we can set up Node.js, which is going to provide us environment in which we can execute our JavaScript code. So now I'm moving to the next step. Here we are going to write some JavaScript code and we are going to execute it. For writing JavaScript, I'm not going for any specialized editor. I'm just using Notepad++. So you can go for either Notepad or Notepad++. If you are comfortable to write code in the Notepad or Notepad++, so it will be easy for us to write code anywhere, because here we are not going to get any syntax help. So we'll have to understand and write everything. We will get more understanding about the syntax and code structure. So first of all, I'm moving to the Notepad++ and I'm going to create a new file here. I'm saving this file in my system, and as we know, whenever we are creating any file with the JavaScript code, we need to save this with .js extension. So here I'm giving first .js. I'm saving a file with the JS extension. So that's my first file. Now in this session, we are going to cover what is statement in the JavaScript. So each line of code which we are going to write here in the JavaScript file, we call it statement. Any code or any code line which we are going to write it over here, that is statement. And each statement must be ended with a semicolon. So if we are writing like, I want to print something on the console, so I'm writing console.log. And here I'm saying, this is my first JavaScript file. And each line of code must be ended with a semicolon, so that shows that's a one statement. I'm just going to save it, Control S, and I have already saved this file with the name first.js. In the previous session, we have seen how we can execute this. So first of all, from the command prompt, so I'm coming to the command prompt. We need to move to the location where the file is placed. Previous session we have seen, I have a folder with the name JavaScript on my desktop, and here's the file first.js. I just copy this location, and from command prompt I'm moving to this location, so cd, and that's the location where my file is placed. And how we can execute it? So node, and the file name is first.js. As I enter, you will notice the file is executing and we are getting result of it. So here we have seen first JavaScript code in which we are printing something on the console, and we have seen each line of code is a statement and that should be ended with a semicolon. If you worked on the C, C++, C#, or Java, there also we are ending the line with a semicolon. So first concept that we need to understand here is statement in JavaScript, and we also seen how we can print something on the console. Now I'm coming to the comments in the JavaScript file. If you worked on a Java programming, so there you know, if you want to make any comment, like I want to make a comment, so we can use double forward slash. Double forward slash is used for single line comment. So I can write like, this is my single line comment. And as we know, this is a comment line. It's not going to execute. It's just for information. Like I'm putting some information about the code which I'm going to write here. So that's my comment line, and that's a single line comment. I'll show you by executing this, and you will notice that line number one, which is a comment line, is not executing. Even if you want, you can try it like I'm writing console.log, and so if I don't make it comment and execute it, now we are getting two lines of in the answer, because here we have the two lines of code. But if I make it comment, then I'm executing, you will see only one answer we are getting, because first line of the code is comment. So here we have seen single line comment, which is created by using double forward slash. In the same way, we can create multi-line comment. Multi-line comment is going to start by the forward slash star, and till what point you want to make comment, star forward slash. So whatever you have written between forward slash star and star forward slash, that is comment. So here we can write any number of comment, like this is multi line comment, and I can write like this is third line of comment, line of comment. So we have created a multi-line comment here. If I try to execute this, so again, first three lines are the comment, they are not going to execute. That is just for writing some information regarding the code which we are writing here in this file. So here in this session, we have seen how we can write first JavaScript code and how we can execute it. And we have seen what do you mean by the statement, how we can print some data onto the console, and how we can write comments. It could be a single line comment or multiple line comment. That's all we have for this session. Thanks for watching this video.